Hi guys, today I will show you how to troubleshoot your Opel Insignia adaptive type bi-xenon headlight. I will show you, if you don't have a low beam, I will show you how to identify the faulty part. Basically, this is for the pre-facelift models. Don't forget, the xenon system is D1S type. Basically, this is one of the most problematic xenon headlights at the whole xenon industry. And probably you know, if you are looking this video, you know that this is a very expensive, stupidly expensive headlight. And if you have such a problematic headlight, probably you already change a couple of times xenon ballasts or the headlight. The xenon headlight ballast is located underneath the headlight. As you can see, it is Hella made 5DV009720 middle line 00. This is the only xenon ballast that Opel Insignia xenon headlight used. Any other ballast from same shape, same plug, everything same, any other ballast from, let's say, Skodas, from Nissans, with different numbers on here, as you can see, this one is from the Nissan, actually. It's also used at Skoda models and a lot of other models. 5DV009610 middle line 00. These are not interchangeable. Opel Insignia uses exactly this ballast unit, which should end with 720 middle line 00. Otherwise, your adaptive function, IFS function, will not work, and you will have a error at your dashboard. I will show you in details in a minute. As stated, ballast unit is located underneath the headlight. By the way, for the last 10 years, we never ever get any intact xenon headlight. All Opel Insignia headlights we get had some kind of damage. As you can see, this is repaired headlight with plastic welding. If you have a condensation issue, here you can see that the other leg also is broken. If you have a condensation, water ingress, or moisture issue with your Insignia headlight, it's very, very difficult to repair, to fix this headlight. The glue or the silicone doesn't help. The only way to repair this headlight is to make a plastic welding on the cracks on the casing. Let's see the xenon system. Here is your low beam and the high beam. This is a bi-xenon headlight. As stated earlier, this is D1S type xenon system. You have a D1S xenon bulb. And basically, if you don't have a low beam, it means that either your ballast unit is faulty or your xenon bulb. In order to identify which part is faulty, you should do a single swap. First, you have to take the working bulb from the working headlight from the other side. You have to put it to the faulty headlight. And if you still do not have a low beam, it means that you have to take down your headlight and replace the ballast unit. Let me show you how to remove the bulb. Basically, if you have a screwdriver, you can push down the plug, and then you will have to turn counterclockwise, quarter turn, the bulb together with the bulb retainer. Here, the bulb retainer and the bulb comes together. And when you are fitting, you have to do exactly the same thing in reverse order. Again, you have to put the bolt retainer first. If assuming that this is the replacement working bolt, first of all you have to put the in correct position the retaining ring. In any case, you cannot put the fit the retaining clip in another position. You have to observe and lock it. And then again, simple. It's about 11 o'clock position orientation, and then you have to just simply turn it clockwise. That's all for the bulb replacement. By the way, if you are missing a rear cover, you have to know that the number, Hella number, for the rear cover and also for the other cover is the same. 236 137 middle line 00. If you Google it, you will find it. You can purchase it in case of it's missing. The rear covers are very important. You have to have the seals. If you have a broken rear cover or whatsoever, you will have a condensation, you will have a moisture issue in your headlight, and this rear cover will cost you at least 100-150 euro if you end up with such a faulty burnt ballast unit. Indeed, let me show what's important for the Hella Opel Insignia pre-facelift Xenon headlight is that, as stated earlier, you have to have exactly this number, this Hella number. Basically, the system is same also in Skoda and in Nissan, but be careful. As stated earlier, they will not work with the Opel Insignia because Opel Insignia has a IFS adaptive type headlight, which communicates with your steering wheel sensor with the steering wheel, and at the same time also communicate with the other side headlight. And depending on your steering wheel position, this ballast unit also tells your Xenon headlight projector to move right or left, which is the adaptive type function. Otherwise, if you use the other same shape, same plug Xenon ballast, you will have your Xenon light bulb will light up, but it will not be regulated. It will point out the very front of your car. Basically, you will not have a dip meme. It will only light. That's all. As you see, the system is pretty much same. This is the Insignia ballast. This is also the Insignia ballast. They both power the Xenon bulb, but powering the Xenon bulb is not the issue here. As stated earlier, this stupidly expensive ballast, it's expensive, by the way, not for any other reason, because just for this reason, because it doesn't have any other replacement, cheap replacement option. You have to buy it exactly this part, exactly either from your Opel or from independent source supplier. There are a lot of China-made Opel Insignia ballast unit at the online marketplace, but none of them are totally working with this Opel Insignia Xenon headlight, because as I stated, this is not only a simple transformator in this case, this is also a software which is communicating with your dashboard, with your steering wheel sensor, and at the same time with your other headlight. So don't make the mistake and don't make experiments by buying China-made ballast units, which will only power up your xenon bulb, but your, as stated, your light will be at the very front of your head of your car. So you basically will not have any dip beam. And the last point that I want to make is, if you have such a damaged Insignia headlight, although the new one cost over 800 euros, maybe it will be better to replace your headlight instead of changing your ballast unit in every week, month, or every 2 months, whatever, depending on how severe is your moisture problem at your headlight. I guess this is all for Opel Insignia first generation bi-xenon adaptive type headlight. Thanks for watching, guys, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All the best. Bye bye.